Hello, everybody. This is Napa Fan here, and this is race number 12 in season number 6 of the NOFSRL Turkey Hill Truck Series here on Black Friday at the Chicagoland Speedway. This, the Menard's 225, a 38-lap event around this mile-and-a-half racetrack in Joliet, Illinois. It is going to be a wild one as we end the second third of the season here in the Turkey Hill Truck Series and head off to the home stretch of the final six races next week at Pocono. It's still a long ways before we crown a champion, though. Seven races remain, and this championship is far from over. But two of our main championship competitors are starting inside the top five. So alongside Trey Wright, what do these guys, specifically Dan Park and Fisher G, need to do in this race to pull away from the rest of the field in this championship here tonight?
Well, to expend an old Darrell Waltrip quote, old age and treachery will always trump the new age and the inexperience in racing. As we are currently seeing that with Fisher G and Dan Park running away from these rookies. But I'd just say just keep being consistent. Don't screw anything up during the championship battle, or any of the races for that matter. And hopefully this championship battle will knit up into a pretty tight and a more tighter battle.
We'll have to see what happens. Like I mentioned, seven races remain in the championship, and it could be between Dan Park and Fisher G this year, just like it was between Andrew Ross and John Arndt last year. But you never know, when those guys back in there, they could get a really good run at the end of the season. Guys like John Arndt and Andrew Ross, you never know when they could just find their way inside the top five in points all of a sudden and come away with a shot at the title. But either way, Dan Park knows he's got that shot. Going for his fifth win of the year, trying to tie John Arndt for 2019 race victories. Of course, John Arndt with the five wins on the year last week at Gateway. Dan Park trying to do the same in the next week at Chicagoland. He's alongside the 78 machine of McAngelo and the Wangwu. That's his best starting position in quite a while. He won in Las Vegas, but he'll win another mile-and-a-half racetrack in the Turkey Hill Truck Series. Matt Tuck alongside Adam Garcia in row number two. Points leader Fisher G alongside Alexander Rowe. We have not seen much of Alexander Rowe all year on Napa Fan. We'll have to see if he get a good run on the number 19 machine here tonight. Sebastian Cook along one at Texas World alongside Joshua Rush. Then it's Joe Rutkowski and Chris Skinlark in row number five. Everybody's going to roll off. We got two championship contenders starting up front. Do you think one of those guys are going to win? Will it be somebody else in victory lane here tonight in the Menards 225?
It's honestly a toss-up to me, Napa Fan. It's going to be a crazy race. It's going to be even crazier than Walmart Shopping Center on Black Friday. So I'm going to go with Dan Park is going to go win from the pole. So let's
see if he can do that. Dan Park, McAngelo and the Wangwu on the front row. Happy Black Friday, everybody. Let's get this one started from Chicagoland. You won the number two, Dan Park, heading into the pit lane on the lap of the race. That is huge in the championship hunt, and that is really going to hurt Dan Park. Matt Tuck's going to lead lap number one, but Fisher G got stuck on the outside lane here, and that might not be the place to be here at Chicagoland, but that is huge. Dan Park with some sort of issue. I'd imagine this might be a tire issue, so he's going to have to hope for a caution right now, or otherwise, he's going to go a lap down and will not win this race. But Matt Tuck pulling away, Jason Tucker side by side between Chase Marks and Alexander Rowe for third.
Extremely tough break for that two truck. Obviously a tire early mechanical issue, or a tire issue as he said. And that is exactly what Fisher G wants to see, but he's got a lot of trucks around him. We had an Oklahoma-style land rush going into 3 and 4, so if he can get out of that outside line. Look at the... everybody just stacked up 3 and 4 wide all in the back. These guys are crazy. But as long as Fisher G, if he can get on that inside lane and pick up a couple positions, he'll lengthen his lead quite a bit over Dan Park.
Exactly, like you mentioned, what Fisher G needs in this championship hunt, he's doing exactly what Nathan Bear did in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series this past year. He's dominating and pulling away from the rest of the field, and Fisher G currently inside the top 10 with his arch rival in the pits. And it doesn't look like Dan Parks can get out of there anytime soon either. One thing I would like to mention, we will have pit stops in this race as well. We don't exactly know what the fuel window is for these guys, so keep in mind we could possibly see two stops here tonight. Not entirely sure what it's going to be like, but either way, we know that Matt Tuck's good. He's led every lap so far here at Chicagoland. There goes Alexander Rowe to the inside, trying to take second away from the 82 of Jason Tucker. We saw that inside lane work quite a bit in the Krispy Kreme Series race, but these guys have a little bit less drag than the Krispy Kreme Series machines, and I'd imagine it's going to be a little bit more difficult to make a pass here tonight at the Chicagoland Speedway, and that has been evident so far in the first six laps of this event.
You see Fisher G, he's moved his way to the inside lane. He's up already back in the fifth position. He already has a strong truck. He's got the 14 truck of, looking at the list right here, Chase Marks right behind him. So, no, Chase Marks dived to the inside. That's more another truck diving to the inside of Chase Marks. So, Fisher G, he's got all open space around him. So, he's going to try and pick up a couple more positions. As these guys are starting to condense up in front of him, he's going to try and take advantage of that and maybe even get into the podium position. There it goes down to the inside.
Try to get a run on Joe Rutkowski for the fourth position. Matt Tuck missed the apex, but it looks like he was just doing that to get a run off the top. Jason Tucker had to slip up a little bit right there, and Alexander Rowe with a run there to the inside of him for second. Fisher G now with a run on Joe Rutkowski. Have to see how well this inside lane can work. If you got some drafting help in an inside lane, usually you're able to make the pass. But it comes at a price. See all the ground that those guys lost to Matt Tuck right there. And number 19 of Alexander Rowe going to clear. And Tucker lost it. And he's going to fall back on the way outside lane. That's something we're going to see a lot of tonight. Those guys get stuck in that third line and they fall way back.
Mr. G, in just two laps, he's already gotten up to third. He's going to try and go for second. But he shouldn't be too greedy. His arch rival, he has an obvious serious mechanical issue. So he can play it safe for now. He doesn't have to go for the win. Just take what he can get, and then he'll extend his points lead a tremendous amount over that two truck. Just don't do anything stupid. Don't make a bonsai move like those guys back there are doing four wide. Nearly wrecked off the corner. But for Fisher G's sake, just don't do anything stupid that could put you in a position to wreck.
There goes Alexander Rowe. He's got a run to the inside of Matt Tuck, and he will clear for the race lead. He's going to move up on Matt Tuck, and Fisher G might get a run to the inside for the race lead. Fisher G has yet to win a race this season, which is quite hard to believe considering the dominant season he has had so far. But a win at this stage in the season for this guy would almost put it at an impossible rate for anyone else to catch him, because this guy has been getting nothing but top 10s all year. 8 top 10s in the first 11 races of the season. That's unprecedented when the ratings are equal for everybody. But it's also important to consider the two remaining races on the schedule are Armory Digital and Talladega. Those two are huge wild card races, and we saw what happened to Nathan Baird at Talladega in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series, so I have to see will something like that happen to Fisher G in one of those two races coming up. Of course, Pocono is another race on the circuit, Bristol as well, Darlington, you never know what's going to happen there, and the Homestead finale is also going to be wild as well. Fisher G trying to get to the inside of Alexander Rowe, not going to be able to get the run right there. Alexander Rowe has all the momentum on the outside lane. And Fisher G actually lost some momentum, and here's a fast truck, Ace Garcia. Where did he come from? All of a sudden, he's up to second in the number 55. And Fisher G, way on the outside, he's going to lose a lot of ground.
Hung out to dry by those top trucks. Like I said, he doesn't need to do anything stupid like that. But a four wide in the back, this could get ugly.
Gotta be careful coming off the corner. Fisher G is way up there, and just like that, he went from second all the way to almost outside the top 10. One guy I like to mention is Josh Williamson. This team has finally found something. That number 99 off of two straight top 10 finishes at Iowa and Gateway after he did not even receive a top 10 finish up to that point. And now he's inside the top 10 once again here at Chicagoland as we go back to the race lead. Ace Garcia to the inside of Alexander Rowe. Now Dale Lightning with a run to the inside. And Lightning, another guy, has all of a sudden found his way to the race lead. But it wasn't too long ago, these guys weren't even inside the top 10, and now they're 1-2 here at Chicagoland.
Like we said, this is going to be a crazy race. Got a lot of slicing and dicing. Everybody trading positions like stockbrokers trading stocks. Have yet to see a wreck, so hopefully these guys will keep it clean. Now that I said that, I probably jinxed it, but hopefully we can have some more of this.
Thankfully, we only had one caution in the Krispy Kreme Series race at Chicagoland here Wednesday night. But there are only 22 cars in that series compared to the 36 we have here in the truck, so we'll have to see how it all shakes out as this race goes along. Matt Tuck also got shuffled out of line. Fisher G has found the inside lane again, but Fisher G is now in the 16th position, and he's still getting swarmed all over the place by these guys. So this is exactly what happened to him at Gateway. I mean, he had a really good run going for him, then all of a sudden he just fell all the way back to like 21st, and Dan Park gained him on the points. But the thing is, he doesn't have to worry about Dan Park gaining on him here tonight. Dan Park is pretty much out of the race, and John Arne in the 05 has also had an issue. We didn't catch that one, but last week's winner is now 11 laps down and out of the race. That's a tough break for John Arne after winning last week at Gateway, winning his 21st career win. Doesn't look like he's going to gain on the points either, so it's really shaken up front. Fisher G trying to hold on the best he can, but it's going to be tough here tonight as he's getting stuck in an outside lane. He's used up a lot of his stuff and falling back, unfortunately.
Yeah, just looking at this for the new configuration, the outside does not work at all, especially if you don't have a drafting partner. Fisher G, he just needs to get back to that inside and just try and salvage what he can. He used up a lot of his tires, and with the new abrasive surface, that is exactly what you don't want to do, as Dale Lightning still retains the lead.
Ace Garcia trying to get to the inside of Alex in a row. Of course, both of these guys have been racing for quite a while in Napa Fan. I'm not mistaken, they both came into the Chick-fil-A Cup Series the same year. So they've been around for about the same amount of time. Dale Lightning holding on very well as... Ooh, this is going to get interesting. We got pit stops right before halfway. That is going to be interesting, especially if this race goes green the whole way through lap number 19. They're going to be halfway next time by. But these guys right here, they're going to have to make a second stop most likely. I doubt that they're going to be able to save enough before the end of the race.
Definitely going to be an interesting pit call for a lot of these teams. I think this is going to be the next wave of trucks. You can see Dale Lightning, Ace Garcia, and all these guys. A couple of trucks stay out. We had Fisher G.
One guy who's going to stay out, and it's only going to be one guy. It's Fisher G in the 43. Now, this is really interesting. He's going to cross the line past halfway. He's going on one stop, and if that's the case, he might pull away with this race victory. But everyone else hit the pit lane before halfway. I might tell you, all those guys who just came down was just before halfway when they crossed the line, but Fisher G in the 43 was able to make it past halfway. That is going to be huge as this race hits the end here at Chicagoland. Whereas now I would hope for a caution so that we do not end up with an issue on the pit strategy, but that is definitely going to be interesting. A very small fuel window here at Chicagoland compared to other places. That is going to come into effect as we finish this race out here at Chicagoland. Alexander Rowe in the number 19. Got out ahead of those guys who came down the first time. Here's the rest of the field coming off the pit lane. And the first driver off was Ace Garcia. We're going to be seeing Alex in a row come across here soon. We'll have to see if he has a shot on the 55. Got a lot of speed right there down the backstretch. Eli Bray with a great run off the pit lane in number 5. He's going to be third at the moment, but Alexander Rowe's got a full head of steam on these guys, and he's probably going to find his way around the race leaders here shortly.
I do like this pit call by Fisher G's crew. I mean, Dan Park, he is currently last, as you can see, he's finished his stop. So there's nothing that Fisher G can do but gain points. So regardless of what happens, he's going to gain points. So he's taking a gamble, and there's really no negative that can come out of this unless, except you don't get the win, you finish a little bit deep, you don't gain as much as you want. But there is still a little bit of metric gain. So I do really like this call, thinking big picture in this scenario. Both little, big and little picture. So he also has a couple lap fresher tires than everybody else. So he may be able to gain, and hopefully if this race does go two stop for a lot of these guys and he stays out, he might just end up with a win. So I really, really like the strategy that 43 team is pulling.
So Fisher G holding on about midway through the field, back to the race lead. And we really don't know how this is going to be playing out because these guys, you would almost assume we'd have to make another stop, especially Eli Bright, Alexander Rowe, and Dale Lightning. Actually, I'm wrong about that. Ace Garcia, Dale Lightning, and and Eli Bradle came down about the same time. Joshua Rush and Alexander Rowe are the two guys who came down a lap of four, I believe. And they are ones who might have to worry on fuel here. But Eli Bright, Dale Lighting, they might be able to make it to the end. They came right at halfway. It's going to be very, very interesting to see how this all plays out. But either way, I think it's a win for Fisher G because, you know, if those guys, if some guys ahead of him come down, he's going to gain a lot of ground. And he might not get the race victory here tonight, but it's still a really good finish and a lot of points for the number 43 team. So that's exactly what they were going for right there. As long as he was able to make that one extra lap, he was good, and he was able to. And I would imagine that Fisher G would be able to make it to the end of the race without having to come back down again. So we'll have to see how that all plays out. But Eli Bright, all of a sudden, has found himself in the race lead here at Chicagoland in the Menards 225 out of nowhere. Race leader, and that's Eli Bright for Zidell Motorsports trying to get his first win in quite some time on Napa Fan.
Yeah, I exactly remember the last time that Eli Bright got a win on Napa Fan, but that would be huge for that entire organization. But yeah, Dale Lightning.
Sports, one of the power teams in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series. Yep. Looking for their first win here in the Turkey Hill Truck Series.
Dale Lightning closing on Bright's back bumper. There he goes down to the inside. And Bright shut the door on him a little bit, but Lightning, he's going to have the momentum going on the inside. And he should retain the lead. He's going to have some drafting help from behind.
Eli Bright's got the outselling to work, and I think the outselling works pretty well when he got fresh tires. It's just when those tires wear out that it starts to fade. This is one guy who really has a fast race truck. He wasn't even in that pack when they came off the pit lane earlier. That's Matthew Logan in the 69 for Tanker Motorsports. And of course, as I mentioned, Tanker Motorsports will not be returning to the Chick-fil-A Cup Series next year, so they want to get one more win before the team closes shop, and they got an opportunity to do so here tonight. Their driver Matthew Logan, we only have 12 laps to go in this race. This thing's almost over. Dale Lightning on the outside lane with full head of steam and a lot of help behind him. He might clear Matthew Logan and make the pass on the outside lane. He did! Power move out of Dale Lightning, and he might have the best truck out here, and that number 31 machine for Coleman Motorsports.
Yeah, but the thing is, he is in a battle with these other four trucks. He might use up his stuff, use up a lot of fuel. He pitted before halfway mark, so if he uses up his stuff, doesn't save enough fuel, he'll probably have to go down. So he's going to need to try and balance the battle and the being conservative and being liberal in this sense, which is extremely hard to do in situations like this. As Logan going back to the inside, he's going to have drafting help on the bottom.
All I know is this is a great battle for the race lead here at Chicagoland. Too bad fuel has to be a factor for these guys, but it is. And three wide, Alexander Rowe with a move to the inside of Logan and Lightning, and he might get it right here, but three wide for the race lead, and they're going to stay three wide down the backstretch. And that's going to allow these guys to close back in. Rowe's going to keep the inside on Logan and Lightning, and Lightning's going to fall back in the 31. Logan on the outside lane. Oh, that was close right there between Joshua Rush and Alexander Rowe.
Contact right there.
Well, we have gone caution-free in this entire race so far, and that's one thing about the reconfiguration. These guys are able to keep it together a little bit better. Josh Williamson, Matt Tuck have closed back in on this pack. Same with Cole Sampson, Trey Smith, Jason Tucker, Andrew Ross, and looky here, it's Fisher G in the number 43. Currently 13th right now. He's at the back of this field. And we believe that he can go the rest of the way on the tank of gas that he currently has. The rest of the field, we really don't know. But either way, we're almost at the end of this thing. Only 8 laps to go in the Menards 225 at Chicagoland. Shane Lake all of a sudden up to second. Where have these guys been coming from? Like all of a sudden they're there in the race lead. I haven't even seen them the whole race. But Shane Lake, driver's second career Napa Fan win. Joshua Rush is up here. And Matthew Logan going for his first career win. Josh Williamson also doing the same. Matt Tuck for his first win of the season as well. A lot of guys with a great opportunity in the race victory. Alexander Rowe has fallen all the way to the back of this pack behind Matthew Brown and Cole Sampson. Well, Fisher G is moving his way through the field in the 43. Somebody's off the pit lane. That's Madison Tall. And I don't know what the deal was with her, but she must have had some sort of issue, but she is going to get in the way of this lead pack right here.
This is going to be interesting. Lap traffic, didn't even know that was going to be a factor. Tall's going to slow them down a little bit.
And Logan to the inside. He's going to keep Shane Lake behind him. I imagine that Madison Toll does not have an issue that's going to slow her down. She's going to be able to keep up with these guys. The Atlanta race winner right there in the 54. This is getting really, really interesting here at the Chicagoland Speedway. These guys are all nervous on the fuel mileage. They're in a draft right now. Do you think any of these guys are trying to save fuel?
I definitely would be trying to save fuel. You got a draft going. You're already going a little faster than normal. Just let off the gas just a little bit. Save as many ounces of fuel as you can. Try and make it to the end as much. But that's it for everybody except for Fisher G. He's going full pedal to the metal in that 43 truck.
And he has found himself inside the top 10 right here. On the outside of these guys, we're coming to four laps to go. Shane Lake will clear Matthew Logan for the race lead. And Shane Lake with a lap lead right there. And also keep in mind, Fisher G also has a bonus point towards the championship as well for leading a lap in this race, for staying out longer than anybody else. So that's also towards the championship. But either way, Fisher G is in the best position of all these guys, and he's the points leader. This is the absolute best case scenario for Fisher G looking to win this Turkey Hill Truck Series Championship. It's the two monster cars, Monster Motorsports and Shane Lake, Coleman Motorsports and Dale Lightning. Madison Toll is a lap down, keep that in mind. And it's a third place battle between Jason Tucker and Matthew Logan. Tucker's gonna take it away from the 69 as Logan had to check up entering the corner. We got three laps to go in this race. Will anybody have to come down?
I think at this point, Fisher G, that would just be the cherry on top for the evening if people did have to come down and they got this race win. But he, regardless of what happens, like you said, this is the absolute best.
Sam Adio's down. Sam Adio was the first guy to come down. He came down on lap 17. It's two laps to go. Now, I would imagine that these guys are not going to try to come down coming to the white flag. That's at least what you would think. But you just never know. We've seen it happen before. We'll have to see how it happens. We have seen somebody win on the pit lane here at Chicagoland. Season 3 in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series. But either way, the moment of truth right here. I think some guys are coming down, but not the race leaders. Shane Lake stays out. Did anybody else come down? A couple of them did. I see Jason Tucker down. Alex in a rope, and a majority of the field able to stay out. Shane Lake in the number 77, holding on to the race lead. Fisher G is in the fourth position right now. And nobody's going to get to Shane Lake here. I don't think Dale Lightning's going to have enough.
I don't know, we'll have to
Shane
wait and
see. Lake in the number 77. First win of the season, second win of his career. Shane Lake will win the Menards 225 in Chicagoland.
And a huge payday for Fisher G. Fourth finishing position. Wow, what an incredible race. Caution free, we're able to have great battles all the way around the racetrack. And Shane Lake, a guy who came out of literally nowhere, pulled a Kevin Harvick. Where did he come from? And ends up getting the victory here at the Menards 225.
And the Monster Cars finish 1-2 on Monster Day here at Chicagoland. And we had a few guys come down, but most of the field were able to stay out, including race winner Shane Lake. Matt Tuck, though, Alex in a row, a couple of obvious ones that came down, but thankfully the race lead, the race win, did not come down the fuel strategy, and Shane Lake coming home with his first win of the season, definitely the biggest win of his career up to this point. Getting it done here in the Menards 225 at Chicagoland. Dale Lightning finishing in second. Eli Bright, Fisher G, and Edwin Mendez, the top five. But now Fisher G is just going to pull away with this. And with only six races left to go, do you think that Fisher G is going to have any shot at losing this championship? Because he's out ahead probably by close to 60 points at this point.
Well, like you said earlier, the next six races are an extremely treacherous path for all 36 of these trucks. We have Bristol, Armory Digital, Talladega, Homestead.
Darlington.
Those are out of order.
Darlington. Pocono. Not in that order. Pocono's the next race.
Six extremely different tracks, except from the Super Speedways. All different configurations, all different speed variants. It's going to be a very hard path for him to forge, but if he can get it done, I think he's going to clinch a championship by the time Homestead rolls around. Another thing I noticed, tonight's a Black Friday. The top two cars were colored black, so that's very interesting right there.
Definitely a very interesting statistic right there. But Shane Lake, the race winner, Dale Lightning, Eli Bright, Fisher G, Edwin Menez, Cole Sampson, though. Now, here's an interesting thing. Cole Sampson came in 62 behind. He's only going to be 65 behind exiting this race. So Sampson did his job here tonight. Trey Smith, Trey Bartow found himself in the 8th position. Emily Anderson and Matt Tuck rounding out the top 10. So Matt Tuck was not one of those guys. They're only about, as far as I know here, we had maybe about 10 guys. Everyone from Jason Tucker on down had to come down there. Tucker, Logan, Brown, Rowe, Monaco, and Wang Wu, Fitzwater, Turner, and then, of course, we saw Sam Medeo came down before all that. It's a tough break for those guys, but it's just the way the strategy figured out. We're going to fix that for next year, give them a better fuel cell here at Chicagoland. But Shane Lake gets it done and in the points. And with a 65-point lead, Fisher G holds on. Dan Park with his issue here tonight, 72 behind. Now in fourth in the point standing, Skylar Perry, 71 behind. Even he didn't lose that much on Fisher G. But it's not about how much you lose on Fisher G. It's about how much you gain. You need to gain points at this point. And it's still far from over, but I don't know. It's looking like Fisher G with 7 top fives this season. The next closest driver has 3 top fives. That's all you need to see how Fisher G has just absolutely obliterated the field this season in the Turkey Hill Truck Series. But see the point standings right there, and you know, Dan Park had a really, really good opportunity here tonight, and it just all went south for him just like that. And even John Arndt had a huge issue. That was bad for him, because after that win last week, he had a lot of momentum, had a shot at possibly moving his way through the points. Well, that's all gone. And, you know, the guys that only kept up with Fisher G, Cole Sampson, Skylar Perry, they're rookies. So, I mean, I really don't see any other scenario where Fisher G doesn't lose this championship. But do you think if there's anybody still left in this field who has a shot, who do you think it's going to be?
I think my money's going to be on Cole Sampson. He's been fairly consistent all season long. He's clawed his way up to the second position. He's a pretty young driver, pretty unknown driver here on Napa Fan, so it's normally the unknown guys that get the job done, so hopefully he can tighten up this championship battle and make it fairly interesting going into Homestead.
We'll have to see what he can do, but Fisher G is the guy to beat here this season. But like I mentioned, we still have Armory Digital, we still have Talladega. Those are two wild card races, and you never know what could happen at those places. And Pocono, Bristol.
Bristol especially.
We don't know what to see there either. The last two races are more normal, but even at Bristol, or at Darlington especially, if you get stuck in the outside lane, you could have a bad day there. It is a very difficult racetrack in Homestead. You know, we're going to actually going to be going back to the original Homestead that we've used. We're not going to be using the one we use in the Chick-fil-A Cup Series. So with that, you know, we could see a wreck in that race. So it's not over Fisher G quite yet. I mean, we had Iowa, we had Gateway, and we really were not expecting any wrecks tonight. So there have been a lot of those safe racetracks. Pocono, I think, could be considered a safe racetrack, but beyond that, I don't really think he's safe in any of those places. A lot of wildcard races coming up, so it's far from over Fisher G. But like I mentioned, it is Pocono next week, next Saturday morning. Back on the Saturday morning for some races. Actually, it's the last Saturday morning race we'll have, I do believe. Only unless Darlington's Saturday morning. Darlington might be a Saturday morning. I think it is, but Pocono Mountains 150. That's where me and Trey met. So pretty cool place. It'll be a 15-lap shootout. It is going to be a short race next week in the Pocono Mountains, but it's going to definitely shape up this championship, and definitely recommend checking it out. But either way, we're done here tonight from Chicagoland. Thank you guys so much for watching. Happy Black Friday. Happy Thanksgiving. Happy everything. No matter what you celebrate, make sure it's a good day. But either way, thank you guys so much for watching. Congratulations to Shane Lake on his race victory here at Chicagoland. And we will see you guys next week from the Tricky Triangle, the Krispy Kreme Series, and the Turkey Hill Truck Series action from Pocono. On behalf of Trey Wright, see you guys later. I will see you guys later.
Good night, everybody.